darlings, it's me, ex-girlfriend. Right, have any of you wondered what it's like to be a drag queen? Well, I'm gonna show you. You've seen the title already. I filmed every single place that I went for a week, and I am talking traveling, photo shoots, gigs, washing my wigs in the bath. That's the first thing you're gonna see, spoiler alert, I guess. But I wanna show you exactly what it's like being a drag queen. So here it is, a week in the life of a drag queen. It's a long video, so let's get to it, shall we? Woo!
Okay, so I'm gonna do this as a voiceover. I just filmed clips for a week. As you can see, I'm washing my wig, like I said before. So I was gonna do a photo shoot later in the week. You're gonna see that. And I wanted the hair to look nice and wet. So I gave it a good wash and then I put mousse through it while it was wet. So it would sort of look like, you know, a bit wet. And look how terrifying my wig heads are. They're so good. Anyway, yeah, brushing my teeth, you know. Getting ready to shave, getting all nice and clean. Oh God, what a state, look at me. This is gonna be very free form, so who knows what I'm gonna say about myself. Yeah, double shave because I have a good beard. Do me skincare, that's important, you know, a bit of skincare.
If I was a better person, I would have tidied up, but you're about to see the reality of what's going on in my drag room.
Oh, I talked in the video. Oh my goodness, I forgot I did stuff like that. So I'm gonna have to keep in mind when I was talking. But yeah, that was the state of my drag room. Maybe I'll tidy it up at some point in this week, who knows? Ooh, TikTok transition, I'm so cool. Look how quick I did my makeup, amazing. And look how nice I looked on the bus. I was like, ooh, this light is actually quite flattering. Lovely jubbly. Right, I'm on my way to my, every Monday I do the big queer quiz at our bar. So there I am, terrifying. And oh yeah, a little cheeky look at Cabaret of Queeriosities, a new gig that we have at our bar. Yeah, just, you know, doing the big queer quiz. It's one of my favorite gigs I do every single week. I love the people that come. I get to be in charge of the whole thing, decide everything every week. It's lovely. Everyone has a camp time, you know. It's not really a clever quiz. It's more of like a have you gone on Instagram this week sort of quiz. Can you draw celebrities quiz, which these lot absolutely could not. Wait until you see this. Oh my God, these are supposed to be Beyonce, I think, if I remember correctly. I think they were supposed to be Beyonce. Let's find out. Yeah, I think it was supposed to be Beyonce, what the fuck? yeah, they're terrible. But it's such a fun gig, I love doing it, and you should come down at some point. And then, you know, I get home, go on the bus, always go in drag, you know, it's quicker than taking my makeup off there. So, oh yeah, don't look at me card number, you're not having that. But yes, no, walking home in drag. I'm just waiting until I appear on Keep Bright and Weird. That's my main objective. Yeah, then I get home and first thing I do obviously is take the wig off. I'm well lazy, I barely ever glue them down if I've not got to. Yeah, go on, take it off, girl. You've earned it, go on. And then it's time to remove the makeup. I always use the Kryolan. It's like a cleansing balm, dissolves all the makeup. It's really good and you get a lot of product for the money. And look at the state of that. Maybe those devil horns might be a hint to something later in the week too. Ooh, I wonder. Oh yeah, I just do skincare for ages. You know, I'm 29, I'm nearly 30. Gotta start taking my skincare seriously. Look at the state of that. That's how much was left on my face. Blech, gross. And this is my cat Ponyo. Oh, I'm gonna put as much Ponyo footage in as possible. But after the night, I was just, do you know what? Let's give Ponyo a cuddle before I go to bed. Ready for Tuesday. Tuesday is here and looks like I'm flossing again. Okay, go off, girl. Brush your teeth, go on, lass. Oh yeah, so I'm tall. That's just a common problem I have in every shower. So I always have to sit down, but I like sitting down in the shower, it's nice. Get all nice and clean, you know. Have a lovely refreshing shower, ready for the week. Gosh, I really thought this was gonna be more interesting than it is. How boring already. I don't know why I filmed that way either, just so I could maybe show you the plants, I don't know.
Oh. Exactly what I did.
No, darling, that did not work. Yeah, that's it. Skincare again. All the skincare, all the time. Because I'm so scared of looking old. Trying to keep on it while I can. Oh, emo. Emo alert. Oh, and Ponyo. Ponyo had the snip, so he had to have that cone on. It was so sad. Right. Oh, I remember what I did. I tidied the drag room because it was an absolute state. Yeah, what a nightmare. Oh my gosh. So I actually was tidying. As you're gonna see later in the week, I actually went to Lithuania for a gig, and I could not in good conscience leave my drag room an absolute state. Because James does use that room as well, James, my fiancé. He uses it to sew, he uses it as his office in the mornings. So I couldn't leave it that much of a state. And yeah, it's just nice to like tidy stuff sometimes and get a little bit of like a, oh, I'm feeling good again, this is nice, you know? Like, I always feel good when everything's clean. So give it a good bit of a clean, and then I knew when it would come time to pack to go to Lithuania, I wouldn't do a terrible job of it. And I clearly thought this was a very interesting angle. This is all my hair stuff. I sort of keep everything in separate bins just so I know where everything is when I need it, when I'm rushing around because I'm literally always late. Nice and clean. Nice and tidy. Everything's, I mean, the state of my table, I do actually clean that at some point. I can't remember if it's in this video or if I did it after this week, but everything's nice and tidy again. Fabulous. All my costumes in organized order. Lovely jubbly. All my wigs nice and ready to go, ready to wear. Yeah, I love tidy stuff. Mary Kondo in the shit out of that room. Oh yeah, and I cooked myself some dinner while I was doing that, but I forgot to film that. So this was my dinner finished. I like to call it like a rainbow Cajun chicken rice thing. It's lovely. Having a little bit of a scran while watching Trixie and Katya, you know. Ready for Wednesday. So Wednesday is photo shoot day. And as you've all seen by now, Revenge's new night is called Confession. And I was asked to be like a horny devil, like a sexy devil for the photo shoot. So of course I had to paint my face red, and I'd never done it before, but you know, it went all right, as you can see. Only took me like an hour and a half or so, not too long. Just getting that sexy, smoky, sultry, dark look, and yeah, gorgeous. Look at me. Oh, sexy devil woman. I'm stunning.
It is hard.
Hey up, James.
Very hot.
Yes, it was hot. Probably the hottest day of the year. Perfect day for me to choose to wear a red morph suit and PVC. But this is the little route that I always go on. Whether James drives me, I get the bus, whatever. It's such a lovely route to go on from Saltdean to Brighton. Just getting to look at the ocean and the countryside. It's absolutely stunning. Only about 10 minutes as well, not too bad. Brighton pier. It's getting camp. We're getting to the gay city. Here we go. Oh, gorgeous. Yeah, it was a really, really hot day. So muggy, so humid. But look at me! Oh! I think they were scared of me using that whip, actually.
Cheap Claire's horn.
Very good friend of mine, Joey, actually lent me those horns. And then this look was made, not the massive marital aid. I was asked to hold that, but this look was made by Tom Bald, Bald Eagle Design. Love him, the work is amazing. And that was the state of me afterwards, because it was hot. It was hot. So I had to walk back to get the bus, so I could go home and start packing for Lithuania, because our flight was so early in the morning that I had to go and stay in London the night before, because there wasn't a train early enough from Brighton to get me to the airport. So I had to go and stay with the lovely Poppycock, who you're going to see a lot of in this video. But first, of course, it was time to take the makeup off, and I was a bit panicked because I'd never used that red makeup before, and I was thinking, oh god, is it going to be absolutely awful? Is it going to really, like, stain me? But thankfully, other than looking terrifying, like the creature from The Conjuring or something, it actually came off alright, kind of easy. Yeah, it was nice. And then, you know, got all clean. Got all packed up. Oh, I forgot to film packing, but we did it. It took me ages, but I managed to get everything in that I would need to do three separate looks and numbers in Lithuania. So then James drove me to the train station so I could go and stay with Poppy and Brighton at night time. So beautiful. Even through the city, with all these probably freshers going all over the place. Those youngsters. Here we go. Goodbye, James. See you in 3 days. Love you. I was trying to be dramatic. I don't think it worked. I just looked a bit of a plonker. And I like it when the train's nice and empty because I don't normally get to sit down. I usually only get the train to London when I'm going to brunch in the mornings, and it's always rammed, so I just have to sit on the floor every single time. And oh, I was on a diet, but I was like, fuck it, I'm on a holiday for 3 days, I'm gonna have some snacks, so I had some really nice food. And yeah, taking the multiple train journey to get to where Poppy lived. I actually don't remember what it was called now, somewhere near London. I know you can see the O2 from there, I think I filmed that as well, so we get to see the O2. But yeah, lots of trains, really late at night. Poppy was probably just like, girl, I just wanna go to sleep, and I was like leisurely taking my time getting loads of trains. But here we are. Oh, yeah, this is the view from Poppy's gorgeous balcony. I don't want to dox her, but this is where she lives. So, you know, if you're desperate to find her, use this. Contact one of those geolocator people to tell us where it is. Those lights in the distance is the O2 Arena. Very fancy. It was very foggy, so you couldn't really see. Poppy's bathroom. Poppy's guest bathroom being bigger than my actual bathroom. And then it was sleepy time. The sofa was massive. I actually managed to get a tiny bit of sleep, maybe like an hour, ready for the next day. And we got up bright and early. I think I maybe got an hour's sleep, getting the taxi to the coach station, which Poppy very generously organized. Oh, look, Parliament. Very fancy, felt like a tourist. We were both so knackered, just trying to figure out where we're supposed to go. And I think we had like a good hour until our coach. So there's all the coaches. And then we got on the coach, you know, it was nice. And this is going to be the start of a segment that I'm going to like to call, oh my God, how is Poppycock asleep? Okay, so as you can see, here is Exhibit A, Poppy asleep. So, you get to be the guest star. She literally is the guest star as well, because she is in almost all of the shots while I'm in Lithuania. Because she managed to sleep constantly, and I was so jealous. Lovely airport vibes. I've never been to Luton before. Our plane was delayed. I've literally just, this is like trauma. It's coming back to me watching this video. Our plane was delayed, but you know, it was fine. We got there really early for no reason. That is the saddest looking crap I've ever had. It wasn't that nice either. Poppy managed to sleep again, you know, just sleeping. Ding. I'm gonna put an actual ding sound in, fuck this. We had priority boarding, which was lovely. Thank you to the organisers for giving us that. So we managed to get on nice and quick. And this was our plane. I felt like such a YouTuber vlogger. Just like, oh my God, our plane, so slow. Poppy had the window seat both times, so I had to film as best I could us taking off. But it always excites me because I don't get to go abroad very often. It was lovely. Off we go. I love these views so much. Oh, look at it. The UK is stunning. You just gotta go really far away from it so you can't see all the litter. And the sky, gorgeous sky. Bloody raining now, not like that now. And here we go, Poppycock asleep again. Barely even taken off. Seatbelt sign still on. Sleeping away through it all. An absolute pro. And then we got there. Lithuania, look, my shoelace was undone. I nearly fell over, I bet. And we had this little bus to go on to get to the other part of the airport, which was absolutely rammed. I was like, how is this bus even gonna move? It is insanely rammed, but you know, we did it. Goodbye plane, see you again in 3 days. And it was so, the weather was gorgeous in Lithuania because the sun was still out, but it was maybe like 10 degrees cooler than the UK, so it was actually manageable. It was really nice. It wasn't that horrible sticky heat. But yes, this was us going through the Vilnius, I think you say Vilnius? Vilnius, I'll correct myself later if I got it wrong. Airport, it was very clean, very lovely. Put London Airport to shame, that's for sure. And then this is Krasna, who you can see in the stripy top. And Artius, the person who booked us and organises our hotel and everything. So we stayed in the corner hotel, and this is my room. I mean, you never know, maybe they haven't changed the code. Maybe go check it if you're in Lithuania. I'm just kidding, maybe don't do that. I don't think the code will still be right. But yeah, it was a cool little touch pad thing. I was very excited, you know. I don't do very many fun things, so this is very exciting. This was my room. I had two single beds to choose from. Very nice. Nice little view as well. lovely and clean everywhere. I love doing a little hotel tour when I get in. Shower was fabulous. Here we go, there's me after not sleeping at all. We went for a nice little coffee in the old city. Hello, Krasna, hello. Krasna's from Belgium, very, very talented. You're gonna see a little bit of them later. But it was such a beautiful day. I had an amazing day. And then this was the venue. This was Soho Club, and it is so camp. The way it's decorated, gorgeous, so fun. There's like a club side and then the performance side. So this is the nightclub side. And it was so lovely. They did an amazing job of decorating it. I felt so at home there. And then this is the stage where we were here for a light and sound check for the day. So just to make sure that the show was amazing. The show was called Dramatica. And this is our like cheeky little backstage part. It was very nice. We actually got to get ready together. And here's Poppycock singing her ass off. As you all know, I do bad guy all the time. I'm almost tempted to cancel it because I can't sing it like that. And this is Angèle, absolutely amazingly talented, burlesque artist, drag queen, stunning from France. Obsessed with her. She did so many funny numbers throughout the night where she was a monkey doing a striptease, and she did one where she was Mariah Carey, but also The Grudge. And then this is Krasna, very, very artistic, conceptual, art pop Gaga vibes, absolutely loved it. Massively talented bunch. And then we went for dinner in like a traditional Lithuanian restaurant, and the food was absolutely amazing. So we had a starter of like black bread with melted cheese, and it was fried and it was gorgeous. That was Poppy's meal. I think she had some sort of, I don't even remember what it was. I remember that's a chicken Kiev, and I remember Krasna saying they'd never had one before. And Angèle had something with fish because I believe they are pescatarian. And yeah, it was, the food was absolutely amazing. I still dream about it. So I had like these potato dumplings and they were so good. And then yeah, we took a nice little leisurely walk back to work off the food we'd had, back to the hotel where I finally managed to get some sleep. So, it's show day. 12 hours later, I woke up from some absolutely beautiful sleep, feeling very rested. Literally felt like I'd never slept before in my life. It was so lovely. And yeah, I woke up excited, invigorated, ready for the day, ready for the show. And you know, I couldn't be in a hotel and not have a cheeky shower. So, oh my goodness, look at me, I'm naked. I even had to blur out my bits because I thought there was a little bit more blurry than that, but they weren't. So I put a little blur on the bottom. Don't worry, you can't see out. Had a lovely shower. And it worked this time. And there we go. Brushing my teeth again, you know, doing all the skincare, all that wonderful stuff. Getting ready for the day.
I think today is the day to be self-centered.
It's literally just skincare. I feel like my whole life is skincare. I feel like I probably take more time doing skincare than actually doing my makeup. Yeah, taking the lift down because we all decided to have lunch together in the hotel because the food was really, really good. It was like a fusion of loads of different things. I had some Asian things, some Lithuanian things. It was beautiful. Oh, my mouth is literally watering thinking about it. It was so good. Very, very scrummy. And then we went back and had a little chill in the rooms, but then it was time to go and get ready. We got ready really, really early. Maybe about 3 o'clock, which is massively early. Especially for people like me and Poppycock that do a lot of gigs. So we learned to get ready very quickly. But yeah, it was nice to get ready with everyone, take our time and really relax. So it was just a nice process. We never really get to get ready together. And every gay person is an evil okay ever. And here was my look. I did my usual blue eye with the orange blush, you know, just the standard ex-girlfriend. Ready to be sexy for the day. We had like a little meet and greet period where we just sort of met all the early birds and took pictures with them and, you know, just got to hang out and have some drinks. And that was our lovely hostess, Miss Plastica, our sleepy princess, our silver princess of the night. I absolutely love Miss Plastica. She is such a great host. Krasna wearing the coolest hair I've ever seen, made out of a hat. Oh, Poppycock sleeping. What a surprise. Oh, love her. Look at her. Miss Plastica, obsessed. Arguably the premier drag queen of Lithuania. And yeah, it was just so fun just to like kiki and have a nice time before the show. It was really, really stunning. And Poppy took the camera from me and decided to show the world her talent, which is of course opening her legs. That was a bit minging. This is beautiful though, look at us! Stunners representing the UK, oh! Alright, that was enough, I don't think we needed that noise. The funny thing is, while I'm recording this as well, I can't hear anything. All I can see is muted video. Angèle just being an absolute crazy person, love her! Here we go, performances! I was first in the final act, so I got to watch everybody else, which was so nice. I just sort of said to the crowd, can I come and sit with you, please? And they're all like, yeah! So I got to watch everyone, it was amazing. Krasna was absolutely incredible. Love the lip syncing. So artistic, so gorgeous. A little bit of Miss Plastica hosting, you know, sparkling away our silver princess of the night. She gave herself these amazing titles every time she hosted. It was so funny. I'm obsessed with her. She's so, so camp. Love her. Go on, Miss Plastica.
And for me to be able to share my love to people that I really love, whatever. Oh, your hot queen, Veronica.
Poppycock. Never get bored of her voice. Scrumptious. So gorgeous to listen to. And this was a super conceptual way to finish the show. It was kind of creepy, kind of spooky. Angèle just being amazing and weird in all the best ways. Whoa, it gives me like shivers still, I love it. And of course some footage of me, stolen from the Instagram stories. You know, I had to include a little bit of my free numbers. But I couldn't film it, obviously, because I was on stage, silly me. So I got all the Instagram stories and popped some of the good bits together. Oh, it's making me so happy to watch back. Taking a cheeky little bow, I got my phone out. I was like, right, I'm vlogging everyone, just ignore me.
Thank you guys, oh my god, buckets, whatever.
Oh, such good memories.
My wig is not ready for that. My wig has seen some other things. That means it's time for.
Bye, bye, see you guys at the next Dramatica. Thank you so much.
I'm vlogging. What I would give to be back with those gorgeous people.
Now the show is over and I can eat some pizza. Yeah!
Honestly, what a disgrace.
I didn't film all my usual taking my makeup off and getting ready for bed tonight because it's about 2 hours to sleep until we have to get up for the plane. So, good night, everybody. I love you, Lithuania. At you. And I'll see you all in the morning. Mwah.
And we got up nice and early to get the taxi back to the airport. I think we managed to probably get about 1 hour sleep again. You know, well, not that it's going to be a problem for Poppycock, because of course she'll just sleep everywhere. It was tiring, let's just say that. Because we didn't just get to go home and rest. Absolutely not. We of course had gigs to do, silly. So of course we were flying back nice and early so that we could do our next gig. The airport was a lot smaller than London, so it was nice and quick to get through. And we had some nice food. I had like potato, I think it was potato pancakes or something with salmon. And I can't remember what Poppy had, some other egg, as you can see. Look at that sky. Here we go. plane time again. And Poppy's already asleep before we've even set off. Of course. We weren't going that fast, I promise. It's sped up. And so gorgeous. Poppy's asleep yet again. Here we are landing in London. Can you guess who's asleep? Any ideas? Is it ex-girlfriend? No, of course it's not me, because I never sleep on planes. It's Poppycock, still asleep. Mega impressive. And sleeping on the bus? She just never stops. Okay, no, maybe she did stop for a second. And then one of many trains that we had to get back to London. And look, she's sleeping again. So if any of you saw her stories around that time, like, I don't know how I'm managing. Oh my gosh. How I'm managing on 2 hours sleep. It was probably more like 5 or 6, to be honest, by the time we got there. But yes, getting back into London. Oh, stunning. I'm honestly such a tourist. Just like, oh, film everything. So beautiful, even if I've got nothing nice to say about it. Lovely. And, oh, cheeky little Mackie's breakfast. You know it had to be done because we were waiting for the venue to open so we could paint in the venue. So this is Tonight Josephine Waterloo, where we both had our brunches. Poppy had 2 and I had 1. So I was very lucky and I got to rest for a minute before I started doing my makeup. But then I did have to do it eventually. And it was very tricky in a very hot, very dark room. But we did it. We did it, divas. And look who's sleeping again between brunches. Honestly, at this point, it's a superpower. I'm honestly jealous. And then it was time for XL, Dabbers and Drag. One of my favorite brunches that I do. So fun, co-hosted by Poppy. It's just a good time. And one of the best things about it, which I think you're about to see, is that we have a special guest, a stripper. I know, a stripper in the middle of the day with drunk hen parties everywhere. I know, that's right. Here we go. And I'm not gonna lie, he gets everything out, and I mean everything. I've not included that in this, although I did film it and I feel a bit like a pervert, but I haven't included that in this because I don't wanna get demonetized. Not that I'm even on the monetization program. But you never know, one day, manifestation. Oh, a ball, I'm gonna have to cover that, blur that out. Oh my goodness. And we like to make them lip sync, you know, make them work for the money, make them work for the bar tab, make them work for the free shots. They were good though. They're better dancers than me, that's for sure. It was just a good time. And I was absolutely delirious at this brunch. I really didn't know what was going on. And then it was time to go home. Oh, finally. And I'm not gonna lie, I was supposed to be at a club this night as well. I was supposed to be at Club Revenge, but I was so tired that I managed to get one of my gorgeous drag sisters to cover me. And I was very, very thankful because I needed a rest. And here we go. Few more trains to get back to Brighton. I feel like I've been in this station about 6 times in the last week, which is very unusual for me. Gorgeous sunset on the way home, you know, just decompressing, getting ready for the day to be over, where I literally woke up and, oh my God, sweaty me. Every time I wear a wig with a fringe, if I'm too sweaty, it's just gone. It's just gone. Back in Brighton, thank God, ready for a rest. Don't know why they're running. Hope you made it. Going through the station. It was very busy. And I finally made it back to my baby. I missed him so much. Oh, I would do anything for you, Ponyo. When I came in, he was very excited, but obviously I didn't film him straight away. But I was so excited to see him. I was just like, baby, I love you. I've missed you so much. My little baby. And my fiancé was at work. James was at work when I got home, so I had to wait for him to come home. And I think by the time he got home, I was kind of like, my brain was melted. But yeah, little Ponyo. I managed to strip him away from his toys and his cardboard boxes long enough to give me some love. Oh, what a gorgeous little baby. I love you. And here we go, finally sleeping in my own bed. So nice. Woke up to some love from Ponyo. He knows how to wake me up the best way. A gorgeous little angel, look at him. Doing his little paw thing, he's so cute. Oh, see, I told you it was going to be mostly Ponyo. And I just stayed in bed. I feel like I stayed in bed till about 4 p.m., 5 p.m. I want to say. I really had a lot of sleep to catch up on, so, you know, just stayed in bed, cuddles with my baby. And that is the, like, I'm being honest, I'm not showing you a glamorized version of being a drag queen. This is the reality. I just stroke my cat all the time. That's all I really do. And here we go. I was really lazy and didn't unpack when I got home, so all my sweaty, disgusting drag needed to be unpacked. And Ponyo decided to help me, of course. Oh. I'm very, like, organized, and I need everything to be in the right place, otherwise my drag room gets a state like you saw at the start of the video, and I just can't live like that. So I had to make sure that everything was put up to hang and dry out properly and be nice and clean, so, you know, because it's hard to wash drag. So I managed to get everything hung up so that it could air out, and Ponyo was just being cute because he loves the suitcase. Little baby. Oh, what an angel. And I keep my boas in there, so that's why they're going back in, ready to put away. And then I went to go give him a little bit of a fuss before I unpacked my makeup.
Baby.
Because he does need love, because he's just a little baby. And then it was time to unpack my makeup. And I like to, if I need to take my makeup kit anywhere, I always keep all the brushes bundled together in the types of brush that I use them, so I can easily put them back. And then it's just easier to tidy away and also easier to use them when I go somewhere else. But yeah, it didn't take me too long to pack my makeup away because I've managed to get down to not too many products. Which I think is the key, really, to being able to travel and do drag. And then, you know, you've got to dry out those ostrich feathers, because if those ostrich feathers get even remotely damp, they go literally like hair. They go all spindly and gross. So you've got to give them a good dry. You've got to dry them a couple of times before they go back to normal. But, you know, give them a good dry. And then it was time. The tights honestly smelled like sweaty balls. It was so gross. Put all my tights in, take the pads out, put them in the... Oh! Then I remember what I did. I went to go and see the absolutely stunning Ophelia Payne do cabaret at our bar. So the Cabaret of Queeriosities is a new cabaret that they do every Sunday night at our bar. I did the first week, this was the second week, it was Ophelia's go. I am obsessed with Ophelia, she is like the drag mummy of Brighton. We all love her so much, what an absolute icon. And a stunner. And then it was time to go home. The end of a week. End of a busy, busy week. And then the last thing that I usually do on a Sunday is I make my quiz, because it's the quiz every Monday. So, oh, this looks really dodgy, but we do a caption round in the quiz where I like to give people a funny picture to make a caption of. So that's why it's a porn picture. But yes, I make my quiz from scratch myself every single Sunday. And that's usually the last thing I do, and that's how I know that it's time for the week to begin again. Oh, of course, I'm choosing a karaoke song for ex-girlfriend's glorified karaoke. You know, it's all very exciting doing the quiz every Sunday. But that, my darlings, rounds up a week in the life of being a drag queen. Sometimes you do more, sometimes you do less, but the main thing is you have fun, you have a camp time, and when you come home, you give your cat lots of cuddles. Oh, what a fun week. This has been so nice to watch back. Oh, oh my goodness. Love it.
Right, first things first, that was a long video. So if you've made it this far, well done. You deserve a clap. Thank you so much, everybody, for watching. It really does mean the world. If you want to see more stuff like this, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe, like, turn on notifications, all that lovely stuff. You know, I just copied another YouTube saying that. I'm sure it'll work. But yes, thank you so much for watching, darlings. I hope you all have a wonderful day, night, whatever you're doing, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye!